What up, food tubers? Okay, so it's time for a beautiful leftover turkey dish, okay? At this time of year, whether it's Thanksgiving or Christmas time, we do seem to have a lot of turkey leftovers. So it's time for something new, guys, something delicious. The dish is called turkey tonnato. It's basically a tuna mayonnaise flavored with lovely lemon and cayenne. It's a really fantastic dish from Piedmont in Italy. I'm gonna start with some pickles, some garnishes. Really simple. Just put a little pinprick into the chilies, because if you don't, they'll explode. Once they're nicely blackened, I'm gonna put them into a bowl and cling film it. As soon as I tighten this up, you'll see the steam forming inside there. And that makes it really easy for the skin to be removed. To complement the chilies, I've got capers. I love the small ones. They're super fragrant. I'm using 4 little fillets of anchovy. So I'm just cutting these into little thin slivers. And then I want to remove some of that salt. We're just going to add some really nice red wine vinegar. Good oil, and that will really draw out the excess salt so you can start to taste everything. And that really works wonders, it really does. Give that a little shake around. Now, after just a couple of minutes, these chilies have steamed. We don't want the seeds, that's kind of too hot. And the skin should just peel off like that. So what we've done is we've cut those chilies into the same shape as those anchovies. And actually, this is one of my addictions in life. I do this every weekend. I'll do 5 or 6. I'll just marinate them in oil. And over the course of the weekend, I will use them in something, maybe 3 or 4 times. It's just my problem. I'm sorry. So I'm just washing my hands of the chili. Very, very simple. We start the story off with about 2 tablespoons of tuna. It's merely a seasoning. Pound it to a kind of paste. When it gets kind of quite nice and creamy, I'm gonna add 2 or 3 large tablespoons of mayo. What we're making here is amazing in sandwiches as well. Really, really good. We then muddle that in. This pickle juice here, let's steal it. About a tablespoon. You want to use that lovely marinade to loosen the mayonnaise so it's really spreadable, okay? Oh, it's getting really, it's getting naughty. I love it. More in. I'm excited now. It's quite rustic. If you did it in a liquidizer, it would be perfectly shiny. But you know, sometimes imperfect is perfect. Anyway, just a little pinch of cayenne pepper will make all the difference. What we want to do is we want to have a really rich mayonnaise. One last taste. Oh, wow. Okay. I'm very, very, very happy with that. So let's put it together. We've got some lovely leftover turkey here. And remember, you can do this any time of year. Just go to a deli and get them to slice your whole load of thinly sliced turkey. Lay it down like waves on a nice big platter. And then we're going to do little bombs of the mayonnaise. This will serve about 4 to 6 people. Lay the anchovy out in 3 little lines. This is quite old-fashioned garnish, by the way. Normally, I hate that sort of 1980s sort of shaped garnish. But the reason they're doing it like this is when you go in and take a portion, that everyone gets a fair piece of everything, you know? And then I'm gonna go the other direction with the beautiful, sweet, smoky, charred chilies. Delicious. And then all I want to do is now sprinkle these capers from a height. This juice here, don't waste this. Rock it. Look at this, guys. Grates of lemon zest on the top. Fantastic. A little pinch of cayenne, cold pressed extra virgin olive oil. So there you go, guys. Something a little bit more unusual. Totally delicious. Let's do it. Mmm. It's so good. Guys, please give that a go. If you like it, like it. Hit the little thumbs up button if you do. Also, share it on social media. This time of year, there's gonna be leftover turkey all over the world. So share it, get other people making it. And remember, if you haven't subscribed to FoodTube, please subscribe. It's free and we love it and we love you. And keep the comments coming. Thanks, guys, bye.